See those little crusties in my eyes, it's like really cool, right? I'm so crazy, but first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cleanse my eye area because I do see some critters there. So I'm gonna use a cotton pad with some eye makeup remover and just gonna lay it on there and wipe. Like, the eye area is the most sensitive place on your skin, on your face. The most sensitive skin on your face, your eye area. So if you are, you know, kind of tugging and pulling at that skin, then you're causing it to age a little bit faster. I love my eye cleanser because it is very gentle. It's a silicone base. It does not clog the pores and it conditions my lashes. So I get a double effect, you know, I get so many benefits just from cleansing my eyes and doing it the proper way versus using a soap or using my facial cleanser, because that skin needs to be taken care of differently than the skin on my face. So next, I'm going to cleanse my entire face with one of my favorite cleansers. This cleanser has multiple benefits at one time. And y'all know I am a portion girl, so I will dot in areas that I know need the product, and I'm going to use a fun tool today. It's called a cleansing brush, right? Cleansing brush. So I'm going to cleanse my skin by just gently rotating this all over my face. You can do about 20 seconds per area. And what this does is it just gives you an extra exfoliation. So gratefully, I can use this brush every single day. It is gentle enough for me to use it every day, and that would help to, you know, remove dead skin, because exfoliation is very important when you are out in the environment, because the sun is aging your skin, the sun is burning your skin, so you don't want to be walking around with dead skin on your face, right? Okay, so again, just small circles. And by the way, the brush was wet, like I put some water on it, so that's why it's giving that nice lather. As you can see, always do your top lip. I tell my clients all the time because they all forget their top lip. And, you know, that's an area of your face that needs to be washed. It's right in front of your mouth. So, you know, take care of that skin as well. All right. So, it looks like I got it all lathered in. As y'all saw, you know, when I was doing my face, I was going underneath my chin. And you can really go all the way down to your neck, but I'm trying not to touch my clothes today. Yeah, so as you can see, I got it all nice and lathery. Now, most of the time when I wash my face, I'm in the shower or I'm over my sink. So I do have more water to, you know, lather it up and remove the product. But I'm just going to use a towel today, just wiping it off. Yep. So just using that towel to remove all of the products. And it's very moist, as you can see. So it helps to, let's see if I can get my focus back. Yeah, it helps to really remove the suds from your face. You don't want to leave soap on your skin. So you do want to have a nice amount of moisture on your face in order to remove those products. And like I said, if you typically, you know, wash your face in the shower, then that would be a great place. Or if you like to use your sink and get a nice amount of water, And that's also a great place. So I'm going to use this paper towel to get a little bit of this water off my skin. Because it's like really, really moist. Okay. All right. Now my skin is cleansed. And as you can see, it's a little bit brighter. It's coming to life a little. But I know a lot of women, you know, we love to wear our glam and we love to look beautiful, you know, with our glamour and, you know, foundation, eyeshadow, things like that. But a lot of women come up to me and they ask me, like, how do you keep your skin so beautiful? Like, what do you use? I want skin like that. So I'm showing you, like, I take care of my skin. It's not that I just put on glamour and it makes me look contoured and it just changes who I am. And as you can see, I have healthy, happy skin right now without makeup on. So I don't have to put on a whole lot of glamour if I choose not to. It's just a part of the industry that I'm in. So I do doll up because I am my own brand. But the next thing I'm going to do is, because I've cleansed my eyes first, so that skin is probably the most dry, I'm going to use an eye cream. And again, because the eye area is very sensitive, you don't want to put heavy products on it. You want to put very lightweight products and products that have eye in them. So I use my ring fingers, see that, to apply my eye care products. And I start at my outer corner of my eye, and then I just kind of pat my way in to just blend it in. And sometimes I have to look up, y'all, because it is a delicate area and you don't want to poke yourself in the eye. And then I keep my nails done, so I don't want to poke myself. But just patting and blending, and that's going to help to fight fine lines and wrinkles. That's going to help when I put on my concealer. It's going to make my eye area more firm. And it's going to help the concealer to stay in place. I know y'all have seen people with their concealer on and then having cracks and crevices. Like, you can see where the concealer is. I don't want that. I don't want any woman to walk around where you can see their concealer on their face because they did not hydrate that skin around their eyes. So it's very important to hydrate that. And then the last thing I do in the daytime is I put on my moisturizer. So moisturizer is very imperative, y'all. If you are not moisturizing your skin, you are saying wrinkles, 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 come on, baby. And I don't believe in welcoming wrinkles into my life, so I don't recommend that you do that either. Basically, I use a moisturizer with an SPF because, again, as I shared with y'all earlier, if you are not protecting your skin from the sun, it is going to age and burn you. So you have to use something with an SPF. And I know we as African-American women have heard the saying time and time again, black don't crack. I always say it might not crack, but it does age and burn. Okay. So if you are not using a moisturizer to hydrate your skin, to fight fine lines and wrinkles, and to protect your skin from the sun that gives off aging and burning rays, then you are pretty much aging your own skin. So, ladies, I've shown you what I do in the morning. As you can see, I got a natural glow, but this is my skincare regimen. Waking up in the morning, you know, cleansing my eye area with my eye cleanser, cleansing my skin with my cleansing agent for my face, not a soap. And I know that there are soaps out there that you can use to cleanse your skin, but make sure it's for your face. It's a facial cleansing bar, not a soap bar that you wash your entire body with, because again, that skin on your body is different from the skin on your face, and you do not want to cause your skin to age faster than what it needs to age, right? And then also, I use a moisturizer, a facial moisturizer, not cocoa butter that I rub all over my body, not my lotion or, you know, my Bath and Body or whatever you use, because I use my brand, of course, but I don't use body care products for my face. I use skincare facial products for my face. So that is the tip that I'm going to give you, because I know a lot of people say, well, I wash my face. And if you're washing your face with a hot towel like I used to before I knew better, then again, you're really just causing the aging process to just start really, really quickly onto your face, and you are not taking care of yourself. And we get our hair done, we get our nails done, we get our feet done, we buy new outfits, we keep ourselves looking good. So this right here is the first thing that people see when they look at you. So you want to make sure that you have your best face forward when you walk out the door. You want to have a clean slate. So as you can see, my face is already clean and moisturized, and it's ready for the products that I'm about to put on it. So the first product I'm going to use is a primer. And I don't know if I shared this with you all, but I am a business owner with a cosmetic company. So I'm using all of our brand products. And if you'd like to know more information, you can always connect with me on my social media platforms. But just going to put a small amount of primer starting in my T-zone and then just kind of working my way out and feathering it on my face. A primer is used to fill in any dents and imperfections in your skin. So if you are a foundation wearer or not, primer is really good to use because it's going to give you a barrier of protection between your skin and the environment and the sun. So you do want to protect your skin after you've cleansed and moisturized it, right? Okay, so the next product I'm going to use is a brow tint because I like to do my eye area first, because once I put on my foundation, then I'm pretty much done. And sometimes if you're using, you know, depending on what you're using, you can kind of clean it up as you go, and then your foundation will be your last thing. So I do my eyes first, because that frames my face. So this brow tint that I'm using is going to give my eyebrows volume, as well as just filling in any gaps that I have. I do have kind of sketchy eyebrows, so I like to just fill them in. I have a nice shape brow, but I don't have enough hair, in my opinion. So I fill them in, and then I will conceal them just to give them that polished, clean look, because I don't arch my brows either, because they don't grow really full. And if you're like me, this is a great tool to use. If not, then, you know, if you like to get your brows arched, or if you have full brows, then you really don't have to do anything. But because I don't have full brows, I like to conceal them. Yes, yes, they're coming to life. Now, after I conceal them, after I fill them, I will do a little bit of concealer. So I'm going to use a shade that's a little bit lighter than my skin. And I'm going to start, and I try not to look anxious because I don't want my brows to be like up in the air. So I try to keep my eye area relaxed and just paint along the line of my arch, starting at that arch area and then going outward and then coming back in at the top and connecting it. Okay. And again, I'm doing this because I don't really arch my brows. So I'm going to do the top as well. And I love this faux toe applicator because I don't have to be as steady handed if I'm putting it on with this photo applicator, because it does all the work for me. So I just make sure that I'm lining it up, and voila. And your brows, ladies, they need to be sisters, not identical twins. As long as they're in the sister family, they're good. You know, people, and you know, the set, you want to make sure that you make them the same shape. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just blending. I'm blending that concealer in so that it will look more natural. You don't want to look like you concealed your brows. I know I've seen people who are not blending. And when you wear foundation, when you wear concealers, when you wear eyeshadows, any type of glamour items, the key to it is blending. Okay. So if you're not blending, start blending. Get you, and some people, you know, I'm using a tool today, but you can actually take your finger and blend really good. Your finger is like the warmth of your finger tip helps the product to smooth out, because it is just naturally a warm spot on your body. So you can use your fingers if you're more comfortable with your hands. If you've never really used brushes, you can definitely use your hands. I'm a lefty, so I have to kind of angle myself to not get it going the wrong, you know, out of place. And as you can see, I still have a lot of concealer left on my eyes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to blend that at the end when I do my foundation, so I don't have to necessarily do anything else. I'm going to move to the next step. So because this is a quick look, my nose is itching. This is a quick look. I am going to do a cream eyeshadow. Ours comes in a tube like this. You can find, you know, cream eyeshadows are creamy. So again, you can use your fingers or you can use a sponge tip applicator. I'm going to apply it over my lid, and I'm only going to go up to my crease because this is very, again, quick. I don't want to take a long time to look cute. And with our products, a little bit goes a long way. So I probably put too much, but hey, the more I blend, the cuter it'll be, right? And it just gives me a little pop. Mm-hmm. Just a little pop. Okay, so now that I've done that, again, I'm just focusing on my eyes. So I'm going to do my mascara just to give my lashes some love and make them look cute. So if you're not a mascara wearer, the key with mascara is do not try to be a pro if you're not. Just give yourself gentle, wiggly strokes, okay? You don't want to tug and pull on your lashes, right? You want to just give it gentle little strokes at a time. And just, like, I've been doing it for a while, so I kind of, you know, my lashes are not as sensitive to the brush as some people who don't use mascara all the time. Because I use it all the time, it is, you know, pretty much like, oh, you're just putting mascara on. You don't have to work really hard. Okay. So the final thing that I'm going to do is my foundation. And again, I'm using my brand, but this is like a CC cream. So it's a complexion corrector, very lightweight, on the go. You don't have to do a whole lot. And I'm going to just use my blending sponge. And again, I do those 5 dots on my face because I want to touch the main areas and then I just blend. So this is going to just pull up my natural undertone. It's not going to make me look like I have on a face of makeup, but it's just going to even out my complexion, basically. And if you are a foundation wearer and you like coverage, you can use a full coverage or, you know, medium coverage foundation. Just depending on your preference. Like, it doesn't really matter what the foundation type is. The key, my friends, is blending, as I said before. Making sure that you're not looking like the cake face lady, right? You want to make sure that your forehead, you're blending upward, like where your hairline is. You're going all the way up to that hairline. And then where you're under your eye area, you're going down towards your jawline. And because this foundation is so lightweight, I can use it to conceal around my eyes. So you don't want to put heavy foundations around your eyes. Heavier foundations cause the skin to sag because that skin is so much more delicate than the skin on our face. And you don't want to stress it out, right? You want to keep it nice and firm. All right. So I'm coming to life. All right. Now the last thing I'm going to do is some lip gloss. Yep. So having something cute that will pop and make you look dolled up. God has already chosen me. God has already crowned me. I don't need anyone else's approval. I don't need anyone else to tell me that I'm good enough. I don't need anyone to tell me that I have what it takes, because he's already given it to us. And that is just beautiful in itself. And I think as people, we don't embrace that. You know, we put boxes and boundaries and limitations around God, and not really allowing him to be who he is in our lives. And then we, you know, don't take that responsibility for us putting that barrier up. We kind of just point the finger and say it's someone else. But to God be the glory for epiphanies and just reconfirmation in who he says we are.